Our pilot farm has a size of about 15 hectares and is located just 2 kilometers from the town center along the national road. Before we started the project, most of the area was idle and covered with jungle-like weeds and invaded by cattle and goats of the neighbors. To get started in August 2008, a proper fencing was a must. We opted for a combination of concrete posts and living fences made from fast-growing tree cuttings, which are also serving as windbreaks and source of animal fodder. A portion of the farm was leased to a farmer who operated a nursery for calamansi lemon trees. He provided us more than 2,000 seedlings, which we planted from October to December 2008 at about 3 hectares. For each tree, a planting hole was digged and filled with our special soil mixture. That was a very costly operation because huge quantities of weeds has to be removed. This was done manually because we disregarded the use of dangerous herbicides like the Monsanto Roundup. Since we have an abundance of different raw materials like powdered charcoal, ashes, compost, animal waste, etc., we designed a special soil mixture in which almost all vegetable and corn varieties have been growing so far without problems. This soil mixture reduces also the consumption of commercial fertilizer by up to 80%. Our main target is to harvest during rainy season when prices of vegetables are high. Other important criteria are intercropping, crop rotations, and the byproducts for animal feeds. To make the venture feasible, it is also essential to reduce the expenses for commercial fertilizers and pesticides. So far, we are not yet 100% organic, but we are able to reduce the consumption of chemicals drastically. We fill the soil mixture in old rice sacks or plastic bags with the drainage at the bottom. This avoids stagnant water and minimizes fungus problems. Other techniques are selection of suitable varieties, wide spacing of plant, sufficient watering, proper pruning and fertilizing. The use of charcoal powder makes our system also to a net carbon sink, but unfortunately there is no chance to gain from the emission trade. Our agricultural projects are supported by the municipal government, Department of Agriculture, the main seed companies. There are regular seminars for all interested farmers and gardeners in Tigern. We do have already experienced farm workers and management. The summer harvest from March to June was very good, but unfortunately the prices were very low. At end of December, our first rainy season harvest has started. So far, all plants are very healthy and the yield is very high. For some varieties, the farm gate prices are 4 times higher rather than in summer. We have planted tomatoes, eggplants, hot pepper, bell pepper, okra, ampalaya and beans. The first batch of tomatoes carries already about 100 fruits per plant. So So far, we are selling all our harvest to market vendors in Tigaon and neighboring towns. When quantities become larger, we will expand to other towns in our region as well as to Manila. In November, we constructed a nursery. Here we are growing all our vegetable seedlings and we do also some experiments with neem trees. Our very first experimental dryer was constructed in April 2009. The purpose is to test several functions and techniques. It is fed with rice husk and the ashes are part of our soil mixture. The supposed commercial dryer will be designed for vegetable and leaf drying, which is a very important part in the food processing chain. For 2010, the main projects are the integration of animals like cattle, chicken, turkeys and pigs into our farm in order to utilize the farm waste. We are also planning to put up a farm shop.